So, excuse me. All right, so here we are unpacking. And can use the lid to set up on. So I'm 63 and I put a few of these together, so I kind of got it down. But if I can do it, anybody can do it. It's simple. But there are a couple things that you could do wrong that would make your life really miserable. Because these joints, sometimes when you put them together, or once you put them together, you can't take them apart. You can't take this box apart once you put it together. You could take the top off. But that's about it. So if you don't do it in the right order, you can really screw up, like I did. So just take all the parts out, put the lid on the flat on the cardboard so it won't get scratched. Set everything aside. You can speed this video up if you need to. I didn't speed it up at all. I just kept it slow or real time. There's a bag of screws that comes with the bag of hinges, which I left in the box. So now I'm going to grab it. And all the screws are the same, there's just a big bag. Yeah, I left the video uncut and unedited so that you can see that it only takes 20 minutes to put this together, and that's and it's simple. So you just put those reinforcement bars on that top part. They're just some screws. Those bars only go one way. And there's three or four screws for each bar. Those screws, the magnet tip doesn't really hold them all that well. So, that's a bummer. But it probably means they got a lot of paint on them, so they won't rust. So that's good. Yeah, and then this bar fits in the back there. It can only fit on one side. The screws are kind of the holes are aligned really well. So when you get one end in, go to the other end and put that one in. It'll just barely fit, and then you can run the other ones in, but it will fit. It's just about an eighth of an inch off. So don't tighten down the first one. There's about six or eight screws. The hinges have those gas compression cylinders on them. So just open them up, attach them, two screws. I'm having trouble with the magnet. So you can hold the screw in with the hinge. Instead of doing it, but anyway, whatever it takes. So on these side pieces, start with the end with two that are close together, and use your hand and just plop them on there. You know, there's a bunch of, see all those deals sticking up? Well, one end has two of them. And start with that end and smack it on with your hand, and then go the rest of the way. Do not use a rubber mallet. You don't need it, and I damaged one that way. Put a hole right in it, and so don't do it. You don't need it. These you can just line them up and press. When you got it, when you're pressing down, just stick them in there and press. But again, start with the end with two holes. And then put the rest in. Now, at this point, do not put those other pieces together. You got to rotate this thing and put the floor in right now. If you do it any other time, you're going to be screwed. So it's really important. Put three sides, put those three pieces together, and put the floor on right now. And this is actually real simple. It's kind of precarious a little bit, not that bad. Just stick it in. On the two sides there, stick it in two sides. When you get in a little bit, go over to the other end and open that up because it's got to come out. So there's no sense putting it all the way in because you got to pull it back out to get that in. So then you push this in and just push on it. When those go in all the way, they'll click. There's little notches and little hook-like fasteners. And just push it together, squeeze it together, and they'll click. And go all the way around until they all click. There's about six on that side, three on the ends. Okay, now when you get this on, now it's also, there's another critical point. This is really critical. Don't take and put those corner pieces on right now. You'd never get the side piece in. You'd never be able to open it up wide enough to do it. So you got to put the corner pieces on the side piece and then put them on. So starting with the end with two, smack it on with your hand, just stick it there. Same on the other side. Because the way this works, that now that it'll go straight on from the top, see? If you were to put those corner pieces on now, you'd never be able to get them. You'd realize that you made a mistake, and you'd never be able to take them back out without a heat gun and a screwdriver and a couple aspirin and maybe a drink. So it's critical. Put those corner pieces on, and then now see how it sets right on? That's what it has to be. Starting with the end with two. And line it up before you get carried away. And then just stick it together. But it's absolutely critical that you do it in that order. If you don't, you're going to be sorry. Big time. Like I say, these boxes don't come apart. At this point, that box doesn't come apart. Excuse me. Then flip it over and make those snap right there too. So you got them all snapped all the way around on the bottom. Everything snapped into place. It's kind of like a hook and groove thing. Now, you can't put the lid on yet. You got these other pieces that need to be put on, otherwise it's the lid will get in the way. So you got these kind of corner covers. There's a piece of metal down in there that kind of gets in the way. You can slide it really easy with your finger. If it's pushed too far to one side and you can't get the corner piece in, just move it with your finger. You can move it with your fingernail even. These, the plastic, you kind of spread it around to fit over the metal. It's kind of, the plastic's too narrow to slide over the thing without, but just kind of pry it on the, there. It's, you'll figure it out. Now, the other thing that's important is these corner braces. You can put these on after the lid is on. Those corner pieces you cannot put on after the lid is on, so those have to be put on now. There's just these little plastic corner braces, and they just fit in little slots and two screws. The sun makes it hard to see where the holes are. It's better indoors or something, maybe. I don't know. But I know where the holes are, so I can stick them in there. Don't over tighten any of the screws because they will strip out. It's just plastic. There's no metal backing in anything. But these are pretty good boxes. They hold a lot of stuff. As you can see, there's four of them behind this one. And I've put together, this is my eighth box. Yeah, you could take these corner pieces out if you wanted to, but you'd never get this box apart without destroying it. So don't even try. And if you put it together in the wrong order, like if you put all those four sides on and then try to put the bottom on, you're in trouble. Uh-oh, refrigerator repair man. Where's that butt crack spackle? I'm fresh out. I guess I need a longer t-shirt. I have to put a disclaimer at the start of the video. There's graphic content. A screw gun is almost, well, it's really handy. It's not, absolute, but it sure makes it easier. Now this lid, you can actually do this pretty easy with one person. It's amazing. It's not bad at all. Have the hinges opened up, and you set it on an open position, and it sits right there really well. You grab and put a screw in on one side or two on one side, and bingo. And you can move these really easy with a dolly, like you see there in the background. You just plop that on there and roll them around. Not when they're full. I think one of the things about these is you do not want to move them when they're full. They're just not built for it. But they're built pretty good, but just, you're going to have a lot of weight in there and, I don't know. I just want mine to last, so I don't want to do that. It's not like a trunk or something. Now it's got this little hinge keeper here that holds it on, and you just it's got a little kind of an axle or some pieces. They fit in these two little holes there, and you just screw it on. So there's a pin on one side and a pin on the other side, and they fit into a hole. And so that there's it's kind of a little bit of a brace for the hinge to keep the top in line with the two screws. It's pretty easy. Okay, so that was the end of the video. Yeah, all right. So and then you just put on the locking mechanism. There's two pieces, two screws, top and bottom. And anyway, so good luck with your deck, and see you next time.